Aligned to the pattern question, because you can realise what people actually think.
Just an S. S for Southend, S for seagull, S for sea, S for sand. And it's like the sound of the sea.
A snake eating its tail.
A long line. It's quite a long walk.
So yeah, obviously the historical fact about Southend is that it's the south end of Prittlewell. It was just a little kind of fishing spot, and now it's the greatest town in the UK.
Oh God, this is a great one. This is coming shopping with my mum, walking onto the high street and smelling fresh roasted coffee, and I can still smell it now.
I really enjoyed the very first time I came to Southend as a 13-year-old. And I was allowed to come on my own, and I went to a comic book shop and a record shop and a second-hand vintage clothing shop all in a few hours, and then we went to see a film, and I don't know if I've ever been that happy.
Oh, here's my mother. Hi. There'd be music every night in the week. You'd have like between about 50 venues to choose me from. And now...
There was a time not so long ago and it used to feel a very hopeful place, but it just feels gloomy now.
Brands leaving the high street and the amount of homeless people there are make it bleak.
Working in retail, you see that a lot more than maybe other people do in the high street. You see like the dark underbelly of it.
Sort of up and down shape. That's the only rhythm it has. We don't have any nighttime economy on the high street really.
Definitely they'll have to kind of open up to bars and restaurants and stuff on the high street, because that's something that they've not allowed up until recently.
Everything's like tipped towards the landlords and not the people who could actually create good businesses in places like this.
I mean, I guess the buildings themselves are like geological layers in a sense, so maybe some kind of geology metaphor in there.
But we could be anywhere. That's what I don't like about it, that you could just be in any town right now.
We see the green of the dome of the Odeon. You can't help but think back to, like, you know, what it must have looked like in 1965 when everyone was queuing outside to see Beatles or whatever. So that bit of graffiti in front, which is pretty cool.
When you look straight up, those buildings, they're high rise, you have to climb on the roof to get to them, and people have climbed up them and decorated them.
It's got vibrant energy at times, other times it's a little bit more on the quiet end.
We've got two main rail line stations. We get people coming in by car, over 7 million visitors. We need to build on that more than what we currently do.
If you look up there on the left, you'll see there's an old clock, and that was the R.A. Jones clock. And what it was, R.A. Jones, he left everything to his employees, but gradually they lost interest and it just finished up disappearing.
That would be a focal point from the sort of the further end of the high street, that everyone would come and meet under there and then go to that department store.
There's a little space just in front of Lloyds Bank just there, and apparently that's the only public space on the high street. And the rest of it, all that we're walking on now, is privately owned.
You know, this is Bob the Jewel. He's got this shop here and up there, and he's been in the high street for years and years. What would you do to change the high street?
What would I do? Well, I'd definitely police it a bit better. We need more police on the streets.
Hiya. Hi. Yeah, good.
Pattern or symbol? The obvious one is just a straight line. It really is just a strip of shops. There isn't much else going on.
I cannot envision a negative future for the high street in 100 years, because I don't think we can go much lower than what we are today.
It has to be led by people rather than businesses and decisions that are corporate, because those corporates, for me, I think they'll destroy society.
Having a lot more independent spaces and support for those independent makers, doers, planners, away from the corporations to use those kind of empty sites.
I don't think we should be thinking in terms of what investment is needed until we've spoken to everybody and asked, like, what matters to you as an individual, and then let's build that.
That tone where they take over a space, and it's in like the Royal Shopping Centre, it's not like just in an exclusive sort of venue. So it's where the community can sort of come and get involved.
Things can't all be done virtually. It will be somewhere where people feel that they can come and connect with each other and connect with their town.
There'll be more residential places along the high street, and maybe that we need that as well.
Solar punk,
vision is very much, okay, the oil's gone, but, you know, there'll be like a lot more kind of some wind farms, trees, people just kind of hanging out and enjoying themselves.
We may have to make some sacrifices, you know, for a fairer world.
No homeless people living on the streets. I'd hope that that's not the case in 100 years.
And you see what you see, kind of get a little bit disillusioned sometimes. And then as you get further and closer to the seafront, it's like,